Hi everyone, thanks for joining our webinar today. I'm Nau Sarawati. I'm the Technical Support Specialist at Visit System. Visit System are independent representative Minitech for Malaysia, Singapore and Batam, Indonesia. So for today's webinar, it will be ensuring process stability with a control chart. Okay, so a few housekeeping notes before we begin. We have a Q&A session after the presentation. So please submit any question you have and we will try to do our best to answer them if have a time. If no, we will answer afterwards by the email. So we recommend viewing this webinar on your laptop or PC for the best result. So please fill out our survey before you exit the tab. So this survey will help us to improve the quality of our upcoming webinar. So we record this webinar and upload to our website www.bz.com and our YouTube channel, Minitech Malaysia and Singapore. So there's no problem if you miss anything or want to review afterwards. Minitech was developed in 1972, so today Minitech in market for more than 50 years. So since more than 50 years, we also have other products like Minitech Connect for the data transformation and the dashboard. So we also have the Minitech statistical software is our flagship product. And then we have the SPM. It will be for machine learning and predictive analytics, but now some of the algorithm in the SPM available in Minitech statistical software. And then we also have the Minitech model ops. That one is the enhancement or extension from the machine learning. And then we have a kind of the a dashboard to we call it that one is to use your modeling. So we have the Minitech model ops. And then we also have the Minitech workspace. It consists of the template and tools for the lean and the process improvement. And then we also have the Minitech Engage. Minitech Engage is something extension from the Minitech workspace. We consist the inside of the tools template. And then one of the good thing in the Minitech Engage, they will provide you the dashboard and then you have something like you can monitor your process. Is it okay or not? Is that something that one? And then we also have the education hub. It will be online training, consists of a few models, let's say for statistical inference, a regression, a statistical quality control, design experiment, and so on. And but we have another, I know it's not new, okay? We already have in the market, I think it's almost 4 years, okay? We have the real-time SPC. Maybe it will be some extension from today's webinar. So you will see that for the real-time SPC, it will be help you on monitoring and then give you the alert in the real time for immediate action when your quality is varies or something that your OCC out of control of your process. Okay, so if you have interest our product, okay, so let us let's we know and then we can provide information for each this product. Okay, so the one is for today we focus on the Minitech statistical software. So in the Minitech statistical software, we have consists of tools inside there. For quality side, I think a lot of you coming from the quality side. So the most popular tools are available, let's say for measurement system analysis. For those are already follow our webinar, I think last month we cover on the measurement system analysis. And then we also have a control chart. So this time round, We play around with the control chart, and then maybe next month we follow for the capability analysis. And then instead of this mesh A control chart capability analysis, in the Minitab statistical software also we have acceptance sampling and then tolerance interval. We also have some for those are coming for reliability engineering. We also have the distribution analysis. We have the warranty regression with the lifetime. We want to estimate how long your product it will live. Okay, so that one is to have for the reliability engineering. And then we also have for the product development. So that will help after your process is a good way. Good meaning to say that it's stable. Meaning to say that it's capable, and then maybe you want to do some optimization on that. You want to know what is the best parameter, what is the best value of your parameter. So we have the design of experiment. So we not only fulfill factorial, maybe you can for the real practice. I think a lot of researchers were using the response surface mixture. So it will be available in the Minitab statistical software. We also have a business analytic, okay, for those want to further study, okay, about this your process itself, or you want to know about the relationship between them, between the parameter and response. So we have the kind of the modeling, we have the regression, we have the predictive analytic, and then if let's say you want to do some forecasting, okay, inside predictive. You or we also have the ARIMA model in the side of the time series. But for those are something like you want to do some grouping. Okay, so we also have the multivariate method on this case. And then this one is the for process validation. So all these tools are available in Minitab statistical software, but just for to highlight, it's not in this sequence, okay? So you need, can find in the step menu for the harvest testing, and then you need go for the control chart inside the step menu and so on. It's not like in one center for this part. You need to find by yourself where is harvest testing, where is the control chart, and so on. But all these tools are available in Minitab statistical software, okay? So that one is our customer. Okay, so it's not limited for the MNC company or big company. We also have the SME company. Okay, as long as your company want to use the statistical analysis to drive your problem. Okay, you give your decision based on the data analysis. So the way is good for you to use the Minitab statistical software. Okay, and then we go for our agenda today is we try with the within 1 hour. So of actually it's not enough to demo all the control chart type of control chart in Minitab, but this time maybe give you some idea what is the control chart. Maybe for those already use, what is the features? It will help you to drill down your interpreting. For your control chart. So for today, we try with go for the control chart itself. We need to know what is the variation, okay? And then we try use the variable control chart, and then we try use the control attribute control chart, and then we try use more simplest. We using the assistant menu to create the control chart. So the stability, okay? So for the process stability is something like your parameter that we use to measure the process are consistent and predictable over the time. So the stability refer for this part is the consistent and then predictable over the time. So when your process is stable, it will be help you more on this part. So they will help you more consistently on in term of quality itself. Okay, so maybe you can your product will be made your specification okay, meet your customer needs, and then from there you can increase your customer satisfaction and your on your product itself. Okay, and then when your process is stable, also they will help you the cost saving, and then maybe you can get the higher profit margin since you know it. You can reduce the rewards, and then you can optimize the material or resources during when your process is stable. And then the other thing, maybe when your process is stable, you can do something predictable, okay, to help you in managing your inventory more effective and so on. And then of course you also have something that you can reduce your downtime, okay, when your process is stable. And then the other thing is a good for you want to drive be the data driven company, the way is something like when your process is stable. So mean to say that you get the good data set or your data is reliable. So which is you can continue for the next stages. Let's say you want to continuous do the something continuous improvement initiative. So they will be help you more to identify the trend, and then maybe you do some implement changes of more effective. So in other way, as a manufacturer, as an engineer, we want to our process is stable, okay? And then the tools we want to measure, is it our process is stable or not stable, we use the control check. So we you can see that here is when your process is stable, you will see on this part. And then when your process is not stable like this part, okay? So what is a control chart? So control chart is something like your process data must be in time order sequence. So mean to say that must be in order sequence. Let's say it's January, your February, your March, and so on. So must be in time order sequence. And then in control chart, actually, they provide you three lines. So the first here is, we call it the center line, which is it's refer for your process mean. And then here we have a two others line. We call it that one is upper control limit. And then the lower control limit, it refer to the process variation. So sometimes by the default, we consider there will be the 3 sigma, and then here is a will be the below the 3 sigma. So the one is the sum what is mean by the control chart. Okay, so if you have a question, you let you type into the chat. Okay. So in the control chart, actually, we want to see, okay, we want to study about the variation, okay, the want to separate from the control chart itself. You can separate the common cost and then the special cost variation. Common cost meaning to say that it's a nature, okay, you everything you do, you already have the common cost variation. But for the special cost variation, maybe it's unexpected variation. Okay, so it will be go for some our daily. So you go to from your house, go to office. So you already have your own timetable. Okay, every day you go out from your house, maybe at 8 a.m. Okay, but at the same time, maybe every day you can arrive at the office almost 9 a.m. Okay, but sometimes maybe you have the traffic jam, your weather is not so good, so you have some variability. Maybe it can be a longer for by the average, or maybe a bit slower by the average. So the this kind of the issue, it maybe is coming from the special cost variation. So same goes for your process. You have your own target, okay, you have your measurement, okay, your own target, your spec target or something, nominal target or whatever target. So maybe not every time you achieve your target, maybe you can get the below, you can get above, Okay, so we want to study about this part using the control chart. Okay, in this control chart, this common cost variation and the special cost variation, if you're using the mini tab, they provide you the color code. Okay, if let's say the blue dot here, it will refer to the common cost only. So meaning to say that this sample, it will be only half consists of the common cost variation. But if let's say you will see the red color here, so mean to say that they will refer to your special cost variation. So mean to say that in this part, in this sample, you need to drill down what is the issue on this part. You know now is have a special cost variation, but is it coming from your machine itself, coming from your operator itself, coming your SOP itself, so you can drill down on this part. Okay, so we use the control chart whether you want to demonstrate your process is stable and consistent over the time. And then maybe you want to verify your process before you go further. Let's say you want to do predicted. Let's say you want to do something capability. You want to look on the CPCPQ value. And then you want to see the effectiveness of the changing. For example, you have before improvement and after improvement. So you want to see the process change. Is it is good or it's not good? And then maybe you want to see something like communicate the performance, or you want to see KPI inside of the control chart itself. Okay, so the one is the, I think, almost of us know about this part, okay, how you want to analyze the control chart, but I just go brief this part first. Okay, so in control chart, actually we look onto two sides. The first, maybe you look on the outside from control limit itself, whether it's upper or lower control limit. So let's say your process within the control limit. So you consider only have a common cost variation. So nothing do more improvement on that. But if let's say your point, your sample outside from the control limit is upper or lower, we consider that you have a existing special cost variation. So when you talk about the special cost variation, maybe it might be the refer to your pattern and the trend. So maybe before this, I think I see many our customer just look on this side only, outside from the control limit. Okay, but in control chart, you can also observe or verify or identify your pattern or the trend in your process itself. Okay, so the pattern or trend, it refer to your special cost variation. So this one is a kind the kind of the special cost variation. Okay, so the first part outside from this limit, the second part maybe you go for the 6 point row in or increase or decrease, or maybe you go for the 9 point in a row of the same side of the center line, or you go for the 14 point in a row alternate up and down. Or we have something like 2 out of the 2 sigma here, okay? And then we have 50 points in a row within the 1 sigma center and so on. But all this thing is maybe before this, before we using the any other software to the control chart, we can do manually. We can calculate, okay, this one is 6 point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we consider the one is a pattern increase. Okay, because this part, maybe here is something like cyclic. Okay, so so you can do manually before this. Maybe after you using the any other software, all these things, no need to do manually, no need to count by yourself. Okay, software will help you on this part. Okay, I will show after this how to get it all this test, especially in Minitab statistical software. Okay, so we have also after we know, okay, control chart, we have a 2-3 line, upper, lower, center. Okay, but we also have a many type of control chart, but It will depends on your data type. Okay, so if let's say your data type is variables, mean to say that it's a continuous measurement, your length, your weight, your height, your yield, okay, something that is a measure, you can come up with the number, you can touch it and so on. Okay, whatever type of the device you use, okay, you can come up with the number. Okay, you can consider it's a variables. But if let's say you have attribute, something like list of defect, how many defect, okay? So you can go for the attribute, okay? So for this control chart, when your variables control chart, we have another thing here is consider the subgroup size, okay? Subgroup size means to say that you collect or measure your data set in same or same machine, same operator and so on, but just only different in the time order. Okay, for example, okay, this AAM, you collect only 5 samples, another 2 hours, another 5 samples and so on. Okay, so we use the X bar chart. But if let's say you just only one time, only one, okay, every hours only one, or every 30 minutes only one sample, you get it? So we're using the IMR chart. But if let's say more than 8, okay, so you will use the S bar S chart. But if let's say your defect or defective, okay, you will use the P or NP chart. And then if your defect only, looking on the defect, okay, so you will use the U or C chart. It will depends on number of your sample or depends on differentiation every sample. Okay, for example, okay, if you not collect in same number of sample, okay, different sample, okay, and so on. So the one is the all this thing, okay, all this part available in Minitab also. I will show after this. So we also have this others available, okay. It's not consider of this standard one. We also have something multivariate. We also have the time weight control chart. And then we also have the ray event control chart. So because you coming from different industry, okay, you have a different standard you need to follow. So that's why we a lot of this control chart. But the objective of control chart, you want to monitor. And then from the control chart itself, you can differences between your common cost and then your special cost variation. It will be different since your data, it will be difference only. Okay. So I think I will go for the mini tab to see on this part. Okay. More acceptable. Okay. So for those who are new with us, when you open the mini tab, okay, when you open the mini tab, you will see the file, the data, the card, the stat. But almost all our tools are available in the side of stat menu. So how to get it, the control chart? Many ways, whether in the stat, you will see the control chart, you will see the subgroup. Just now, we talk about the subgroup size, okay? What is the R, what is S? And then we have individual. We also have the attribute. That one is for those who want to have a small shift, whether it's in the process mean or the variability, or maybe for those are something like the parameter have the correlation or relationship. Okay, so they we use the multivariate chart, or for those are something like your number of opportunities, something like one, so you can use the ray event chart. Okay, but for those are new with the control chart, so you just open the mini tab, you go for the assistant, you go for the control chart. Okay, you go for the control chart. This means they give you the tree diagram here. So for this part, you will see that the data type. So maybe give you some information before you choose the right tools for your problem. Okay, so you go for the continuous. What I mean by the continuous, it gives you the example. And then for this part, we go for the data collector in subgroup. So for those are not so clear about this part, so maybe you can go for this explanation. Okay, so multi observation are collected close together in time. Okay, and then here is the IMR chart. individual moving range chart. X bar R chart means that X bar is your mean, your average. Your range, it will be the maximum minus your minimum. Okay. And then X bar S chart, it will be X bar mean or average. S is your standard deviation. Okay. That one is something like when you have a most a lot of data set. Okay. So you not only look on the mean, you look on the other side. Let's say for the variability, you look on the standard deviation. So that's why we have R, we have S. Okay. So let's say here, the guideline here is less than 8. So you use the R chart. But it's more than 8. Okay. More than 8, you use the S bar S chart. Okay. Just to remember, a lot of data set coming. So you use the a lot of observation you see on your sample. So you use the they will be the S chart. Okay. So same score for the P or U chart for this part. Okay. So no need to go to Google. You just open your mini tab, you go for assistant, you go to control chart. So which is you need to know your measurement is what is the continuous or attribute, and then you use this part. Okay. Okay, just want to highlight that Minitab statistical software is offline. It's not the real time. So which is you already save your data in the CSV file. You just call back into this. You just go open. You go for the file. You can open. So for example, you save on the, I save for this part. I save in the Excel file. So you just go for the file, open. You see the Excel file or CSV file. So you just can open it for this part. So you satisfy with this part. I don't want this part. I want this only. So you can preview first. Okay. Is it okay or not? And then you click okay. So now you can import Excel file into this worksheet file. Whether you can copy from your database and paste it into this worksheet also available. You can type also available. You record into this worksheet also can. So it will depends how you collect your data into this worksheet. Okay, it's not the real time, whether that one is not the real time. This one is offline. Okay, but you can do the some connection with your database. We can using the file query database or DBC. Okay, and then import into this worksheet and then run the control chart. So many ways you can import your data into this worksheet. Okay, to do the control chart. Okay, to assess your variability. We are go back for this part. Okay. So I have one case study here. Okay. So a quality engineer monitored the length of the connector pin. Okay, the engineer used the two machines to produce connect pin, and then they randomly sample 5 per box for each machine. Okay, so they want to assess the length of the connector pins is in control or not control. Okay, it's stable or not stable. Okay, so this part is the length. It's a measurement. So mean to say that there will be the continuous data set. Okay, so maybe it can be 20.1, 0.2, 20 only. So it will be the measurement. It's the length. Okay, so I think I go back to the mini tab. Okay. I opened for this data set. Okay. I open for data set, the ping length of this data set. So every time, okay, every time they take it 5. Another time, let's say this one is 8 AM. Okay, this one it will be 10 AM. Another 5, it will be 12 AM. So it will depends on your process. It's not fixed like that one. Okay, it will depends on your process. Okay. Okay, so every time you take it only 1, so you use the IMI chart. So for this case, every time you take it 5, so you will use the variables or group. Okay, whether it's R, whether it's a S. So it will depends how many. This seems less than 8, so you will use the S bar R chart. So how to get it? Go to stat, go to control chart. You will see the subgroup. So here, we use the S bar chart. Okay, so that one is something by the default, we take consider one column, one variables. So for this part, it's a line. Okay, so for this part, you just put the line. So subgroup size, maybe you just put or type 5, or maybe you can put another collecting data here, your subgroup. So you can enter your subgroup here. Okay, and then you click OK. Now you will get the control chart. Okay, so why I choose the S bar R chart? Since every time they take it 5. So that's why I put the S bar R chart. Okay, so how to get it? I redo, go to stack, go to control chart, go to subgroup. I choose the S bar R chart. Okay, and then I choose the our variables here is the length. And then I click OK, I will get the control chart. So in the control chart, they give you the control limit. Okay, they will give you the control limit. So here is upper control limit, lower control limit, and then center line. So that one is will be the X bar. It will be here is the range chart. Okay, so that one, it will be the upper control limit, also have the lower control limit, and here is be the R bar. Okay, so since the they are subgroup, okay, they will have this part. Okay, I will to further, I go back to this part. Okay, I will go back to this part, how they get this part. Okay, since the one is a subgroup, okay, mean to say that every time they take it 5. So for the first sample here, okay, for the first sample here, it's coming for the average of the sub 1. So mean to say that this point is not individual point. It will be the group point. Okay, so same go for the group 2. Also, the one is will be the individual, not individual, will be the group data set. Okay, it's average. You can see that all this part, you will see the S bar, bar. Mean to say that the average for average. Okay, they will be put here. S bar, bar here is average. Okay, for to the average for the center line here. So here is your upper control limit, and then here is a lower control limit. And of course, for the R chart also the same. The one is the coming from your maximum number from this group first, minus the minimum number of this group. So you will get this value. So this one is the subgroup, sample one, sorry. That one is will be the sample one. Here, it will be the sample two, same. So you go for the subgroup sample two, which one is the highest, minus the minimum, you will get the another R here. So that's why this line, the green line here, you will refer only R. Okay, R bar only. This means it's average for the range. Range is coming from maximum minus the minimum. So that's why this part is not the individual from your process. It's a group of your process. For those are only one, okay, only one. So they will be individual. Okay, so they will be the individual. Okay, so this part, it will be the individual. Okay, so hopefully you can clear about this part. I want to back to this, okay. So based on this control chart, you will see that this doesn't appear any red color. Okay, mean to say that Minitech help you more on this part. The turn only blue color here, mean to say that all this part is consists only the common cost variation. Okay, the common cost variation. So they we consider the process is in control. The process is stable since the mean and the variation in constant state. Okay, constant, not the zero. It's a constant. It's the same. So you have a trend only. Okay, so we consider this process in control. Since there's not any point outside from this limit, and any point doesn't appear any special cost variation. Okay, so that's why we consider the process in control state. Okay, hopefully you can clear about this part. Okay, I go back to this. Okay, so this one is some tricky or some features are available. So we go further for this part. I go back to the mini tab. Okay, I go back to the mini tab. Go back to the bin tab just now. We calculate on this part. Okay, for those I want to verify. Okay, you do before this, maybe you do the manually. Okay, so you want to see the formula, what mini tab use on this part. Okay, so you just go for this part. Okay, right click. Okay, right click. You go for the help. Okay, you go for the help. And then you see the formulation and the method and formulation. So for example, you go for the S bar chart. So this how Minitab calculate for the plot for the of each point. And then this one is a center line. How many get this part? Okay, so you can compare with your manual calculation. Is it the same or not same? Okay. To verify the formula what Minitab already used for how that calculate the control limit or this software. Okay. So I go back to this part where you see that UCL, okay, LCL. For those already have some historical parameter. Okay, you want to use your own control chart, own control limit. Okay, whether it's upper or lower control limit, because your process is already established, okay, or is it stable. So no need to worry. So you want to use that kind of the value. So we go back to the control. Okay, you go by X bar R option. Okay, one of the thing you need to insert the mean here. Okay, you need to insert your historical mean, your own mean. Okay, and then your own standard deviation. And then Minitab, we calculate the control limit based on this mean and your standard deviation. Okay, so you not able to insert in this UCL. Okay, you can insert, but you just only have reference line. Minitab consider it will be the reference line. Okay, so you may consider it's a reference line. So, and then another features is a good for you know about this part. You go for the S bar option, okay? You go for the test. Just now I mentioned, okay, 6 point up and down, okay? So this one is a refer for this all this, okay? Or maybe you follow on the Western Electric rules or something, that one. So you can see on this part. But the default, Minitab consider only one. Which is a K point, 1 point more than 3 standard deviation only. Okay, not consider the others here. So let's say your standard, okay, your company have your own standard. Okay, so you can customize it on this part, or maybe you want to see or perform all the tests. Okay, but not highly recommend to use to perform all the tests. So you can go for the will be might you misleading on this part. So you can go for the perform all the tests and then you click okay and then you click okay. So we try with this part, same. So perform all the tests also this part, same. Okay, no issue on this part, on this process. Okay, so I go back to this part. It will depends on your preference, okay? But for the variables, actually we go for the test 1, test 4, test 2, test 4 and test 7. Okay, this one is the we always use for the continuous. Okay, so for this part, another tips we can use for this control chart is we want to see the process change. Okay, before and after. Okay, something that one. So you consider that this part is a machine, is a before and after. Okay, or you want to see the machine 1 and machine 2. Okay, so how to get it this part? You can go back to the control limit. The dialog box. Okay, you go for the S bar option and then you go for the stages here. Okay, so for this part, I want to put the machine. Okay, and then I want to put with each new value. Okay, and then here I go back to this part. I just want to perform selected only one. Click okay, and then I click okay. Now you will see that the process change, the mission one and mission two. But I think the practical way in your context, maybe it will be before and after. Or maybe you want to compare the supplier, okay, supplier one and the supplier two. Okay, so you will be help you more on this part to drill down your problem for your control chart itself. Okay. So we go back to this part. I already put here. See the set link. Okay. The change process change. And then we try with this example for the attribute control chart. Okay, so attribute, just now we have a defect or defective first. Okay, you need to identify. And then after you know it with the defect or defective, you need to know whether is your sample size group is the same or unequal sample size. Okay, so the one is some problem. A quality engineer for a wall paper manufacturer want to assess the stability of the printing process. So every hour, the engineer takes 100 feet of wallpaper and count the number of printing defect. Count the number of printing defect. So mean to say that the least, okay? So they will be the defect. So we include the print smear, pattern distortion, and the missing. The one is a type of the defect. So they come out with the sample and then they come out with the number of defect. Okay, so I go to the mini tab, the case study, go back to the case study. And then I open the wallpaper defect. I open the wallpaper defect. So every time, every sample here, they take it 100. So they identify 24 defect. Okay, so the 24 defect, it consists of type of defective. Okay, so that one is to go back to stack, go back to control chart. Maybe you go for the attribute chart. So for this part, it lists and then give the same. Okay, per subgroup, it will be the same. Okay, so you use the C chart. And then here is a defect, the same, go for the defect. And then you click okay. So you will get Minitab, we calculate the upper corner limit for you, your central line here, and then the lower limit. Okay, all we do, go to stat, go to the control chart, go to the attribute, and then you use the C here. Okay, you use the C, choose the C. And then here, maybe you want to further down on this part. So not only one. Maybe you want to see, perform the test, okay, and then you click okay, and then you click okay. Now, you will get this part, okay? So, you will get this part. So, Minitab will give you some information. So, you will see that one here, refer for the test one. What mean by the test one? 1 point more than 3 standard deviation from the center line. What the sample is a fail, sample 12 and 30, okay? So this part, we consider the process is not stable. So to break down this part, maybe you form a team, engineer, your operator, okay, your manager, okay, do the brainstorm. Okay, so maybe 5Y and so on, the technique of the brainstorm, okay, FM, maybe a fishbone diagram and so on. You can proceed, okay, for this part. What happened on this part? In control chart, you just know the status, okay? It's not to solve your problem. You just know about the status. So here is coming from your special cost variation. So is it if from your, if let's say you're using the fishbone, okay, from your method, from your machine, okay, from your man, okay, or from your environment or so on, okay? So you can break down on this part, okay? So but some ideas, okay? But not, I think the actual part, the engineer is not so happy if let's say this part. Okay, we consider you already solve this problem. Okay, you already identify the root cause of this part. Okay, we intend have the feature something like you can omit, okay, the sample itself. Okay, you want to see something like the new, you already assume that, okay, now you already solve the problem, sample 12 and 30. So you want to remove. Okay, you go back to the chart option, okay, you go for the limit, sorry, you go for the estimate. So you can omit first, okay? Just only for your study. I'm not sure. I think the actual part, yeah, the engineer is not so good, okay? It's not happy to use this part. 12 and then 30. Do not omit this part. Click OK and then you click OK. Okay, so you consider that this part, okay? So you will see that, okay, this part is original without omit any point. Okay, so we see that UCL 54. Okay, but here is you omit, you already omit from your calculation to get the UCL. So you come out with the new UCL. You assume that now you already solve this problem. So after you solve this problem, maybe your control chart, it will be this control limit, it will be this value, low upper and then lower control limit. And then your center line also will be the decrease compared to the original one. Okay, mean to say that you already solve in terms of the variability and then your process mean. Okay, so this one is one of the features available in Minitab in for your control chart. Okay, and then another way, just only for recap back, okay, you just go for the assistant. For those who are new or already expert, okay, I think you will use this part. Go for the assistant, go for the control chart. Now it will be the this part. Maybe you go subgroup, continuous, and so on. Okay, so this part, you we have an many ways, whether it's you go for the stack, go for the control chart, or you go for the assistant, and then you will see the part. But if let's say you're using the control chart, we are go back to this control this case study, the line, the pink line. So you will see that the different one is when you're using the start menu and the assistant, it some give you some idea on this part. Okay, for the length here is a 5. Okay, so here you want to estimate from the data set only, and then you click okay. So you will see this part. I don't want this part. Okay, I won't start. So when you're using the assistant, they provide you the summary report, they provide you the stability report, they provide you the report. Okay, so maybe more information you get, but no worries, the value of the control limit, it will be the same. Okay, the value of control limit, it will be the same. So the other thing, the our customer love it, this part is the process mean stable? They give you yes or no. Okay, and then they provide you the stability report, which is you go back to the start, you go back control chart, you go space part, you will see the S bar, and then you will see the this. Okay, so this part, it will be the same like this. Global trend, the cyclic, the shift, okay, the drift, the oscillation, the mixture, and then existing of this part. And then they give you the report card. Because part is a good for study, okay? Since control chart, we consider the statistical analysis, okay? So when statistical analysis, they consist of the assumption you need fulfill before you rely on that value, okay? So you have the stability is good, amount of data set is good, a correlated data set is good, and then they give you the alternative chart. Okay, mean to say that give you the other idea to trade down your process or so on for this part. Okay, so they will give on you the traffic light, the green color, green, yellow, and the red color. And then here is an alternative chart. It's a some suggestion to you for this part. Okay, so I go back to this. I think we already cover all this part. Okay, for those want to this material, so you can drop your email into the chat or Q&A session. So I will share after this. Okay. So do you have any question? So you can type into the chat box. Okay, you can type into the chat box. Do you have any? Okay. We have a lot of question on here. Okay. The question here is a good with a big data, meaning every unit have a data, of which type of a variable chart is suitable. Okay, let's say your observation number more than 8. Okay, you will use the S chart. Okay, as long as your data continuous data set. Okay, hopefully I answer your question. I think this question also the same. Okay, when your data set more than 9, we use the S bar S chart. Okay, for the process variability. Okay, the one is yes, Minitab can do the moving range chart. Okay, so we think we show back to this part. Okay, go to Minitab. Okay, so how to get it? You go for the stat, go to control chart. You use this one, IMR chart. Okay, or you want to see the individual chart. Okay, so here is a subgroup. So, any other question? The one is a good question for the defect data. Okay, if sample n equal 1, which chart type should be choose? Okay. The defect is a refer for defect or defective list of defect on or only counts of defect. Okay. Maybe you can use the P test. This part also the good question when your total inspect again the defect box DPU. Okay, maybe you can use the U chart or C chart. Okay, so for the continuous data set, actually you need to clear up how you collect the data set. Okay, how you collect the data set to decide which is the S bar chart. Okay, the one is a good question also. Okay, what is the data sensitivity? Not enough to trigger OCC. Okay, due to nominal spec. Maybe you do some study before you use the control chart. Okay, maybe for this part, you only look on the pattern. Okay, stability, the pattern. Maybe also your parameter have an interaction with other parameter. Okay, so now maybe you cannot be use the basic control chart. Maybe you use the multivariate. Okay, you use the T generalized variation. Okay, so for those want to know how many data set is a good for control chart, I go to the stat, go to the control chart. I go for the as long as you have an internet connectivity, so go for the hub. Okay, you go for data consideration. That one is some information from the Minitab itself. Okay, but Minitab always refer to AIG standard. Okay, so this part. How many? Okay. how many subgroup. Okay, so they give you this information. Okay. So I think other question I will reply after this. Okay, so go back to this part. So for those have other questions, so let drop your email to nor.sulawati@thebusiness.com. Okay, regarding this webinar or others question about the mini TED tools. Okay, and then. Of course, for today, I just focus on the SBIR chart and then some features. Maybe your question, let's say, okay, for this data set, is it enough only for use the SBIR chart? Maybe you can go for the advanced EWMA. So what is the difference between short run, between the AE and WMA when you want to use this part, okay? So that one is the for you, okay, to drill down for this part. We have a comprehensive training for the statistical quality analysis, okay, consists of 2 days training, whether in Singapore or Malaysia. So I think I drop the link, okay, for you to get more information on this part. I paste it into the chat. Okay. So for those who want to, you can scan barcode also on this part, okay, to get more information on this training. So, thank you for your time and attention. So to learn more about MiniTED, please contact us by visit our website www.miniTED.com or www.bz.com or email to us to sales or miniTED@bz.com. So to get some tips or trick on our MiniTED product, so please follow us through media social like Facebook and link at MiniTED Malaysia and Singapore. So to access back our previous webinar, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, MiniTED Malaysia and Singapore. So really appreciate if you fill out our survey in order to enhance our webinar. So maybe see you next time with different topic and happy learning.